Hey, what's up, everyone? This is Peter O. Newton, and today we're going to be talking about the DetourCrowd AI controller. And so, what I want to demonstrate here is the avoidance that is applied to the AI controller as it crosses paths with other AI controllers. And so, if you want to simulate a crowd moving through each other, then you can do this using the DetourCrowd AI controller. So what I've done here is I've created a nav mesh, and I've also created a block under it twice the size of the original third-person map, and then I've also deleted the walls and the other geometry and the character that was here. And what we want to do now is go into the blueprint back to this third-person character. After you've done all this and you have your navigation showing up, drag this guy in, and we want to look inside his fields. And so look inside the details panel here and search for the AI controller. And we want to change this to the DetourCrowd AI controller. And now that's going to give it the behavior that we want. But to really see this, you want to add in multiple characters. So we're going to drag some out. And after you drag these guys out, we also want to go and change their walk speed. So it should be 150. And so now that you have the walk speed set, and you also have your characters here, we want to give them something to avoid. So I'm going to drag this square down. Let's delete this one. And I'm just going to create an odd shape out of it. So I'm going to stretch it this way and rotate it. Give it more of a pull. Right? And so they have to go a different direction. And I want to get the target and put the target right here. And now, with the target selected, we want to go and select our characters right here. And then we're going to go into our blueprint and go into open level blueprint. Now that you have this in, zoom in, I'm going to right click, and I'm going to create references to our 5 selected actors. Now we want to get our four actors, moving towards this one actor here. So when the map loads, or we can call it event again, we want to execute the function moving towards this actor. So let's, what I'm gonna do is make an array. I'm gonna plug in these four characters. And then I'm going to do a for each. And connect this execution pin back to this event again. So now it's going to execute this. And we're going to get the controller from this character. And then pass this to the AI controller. So we can access the move to actor function. And with our actors that we need to move towards up here, we can draw from this AI controller and move to actor. Now we have our goal, and we can plug that into this node. So now it's going to tell all four of our actors to do this operation here. So let's compile, and now we can see that in action, right? So I'm going to spawn here, but I could just hit simulate and we can watch this in window. So let's hit simulate, and you can see they all walk around that way. But they do not try to intentionally clip each other, right? So if I were to, say, move this guy here, see how behavior changes. You can see they almost wait for each other. And now if you really want to see this on a grand scale, I have another map I have here created. So we're going to go to Crowd Simulation and save this map. And I'm just going to hit play, because I already have it set up. Now we can really see what's happening. All of them are going to try to avoid each other's path without intentionally hitting each other. And of course they do have the boxes around them. But normally when you do this with the AI controller, they do not make any effort to avoid each other. And so that is the DetourCrowd AI controller. Peace.